Well, for the first time, the choirs at Quincy and North Quincy High School are performing independently at the Thomas Crane Public Library in Quincy Center. Tuesday, May 3rd and Thursday, May 5th, 3:30 p.m., spring concerts. We have a little preview with choir director Tim Carew and some members of the Quincy High Choir representing the whole gang. Tim, it's going to be a lot of fun.
Yes. So on Tuesday the 3rd, the Quincy High School Choir, both the concert choir and the Horizons Choir will perform. We'll open with a set of more formal choral selections, a Renaissance piece, a folk song arrangement, and then we'll move on to another set with the Horizons Choir performing a set of American jazz standards, and then the full choir, the concert choir, will go back and perform a set of American musical theater choruses.
Okay.
So it should be, it's a diverse set of both formal selections and more popular styles.
And this has been performed already, yes, the spring concert?
Yes, it was back in April we performed it at our Quincy High spring concert.
Okay.
And then on Thursday, the North Quincy High, it's a pretty similar format, but completely different, separate repertoire. We'll start with more formal selections, including a Scottish folk song arrangement, and a couple of more contemporary classical style selections. And then we'll move on to a set of another set of American jazz standards, or the American songbook, a great American songbook, as
sure.
they say.
Yeah.
And then we'll finish off with actually a set of 1960s and 70s popular song arrangements.
Neat. Okay.
Including a Beatles arrangement and, believe it or not, a disco arrangement with choreography by Erica Famador from Velocity Studio in Quincy.
Okay, so yeah. Not only just singing, but singing and dancing.
No, right. So Thursday there'll be a little dancing
All right.
involved.
Okay,
as
so
well.
Each show will be a little bit different then.
Each show is almost completely different. There's only one overlapping selection.
Very good. And you brought some representation with you today.
Yes.
Now, why don't you introduce the group?
Sure. We have Leanne here. She's the from Quincy High School, the mm-hmm. choir student president. We have Angela, the choir student secretary, and Matthew Pham, the tenor section leader from Quincy High School Choir.
Okay, so Leanne, as president then, what is kind of your goal for this performance at the library?
For this performance? Well, I think it's been really cool to see over time how we've all come together, and in a choir, it's not about individual talent. It's more about how we can work together as a group and make our voices blend. And so I think this performance is a wonderful way to see how far we've come from the beginning this year. And we've come a long way, and it's really exciting to see that.
Yeah, what is the practice like, you know, the rehearsals for a performance like this? Is it pretty intense?
Well, from this point, since we've already done the spring concert, it's more just reviewing, and we have a really good time. It is also serious, mm-hmm. but there's a good balance between.
It's fun, right?
Yes,
it's about having fun and inspiring your audience, perhaps, and maybe getting a little emotion out of them one way or another, either are they happy or evocative at least, right?
Yes.
Now, do you hope to maybe continue in your career in music in the future?
Personally, I'm hoping to go into the Air Force as a surgeon,
really?
But music is a very, very important to me, so do something along those lines.
Okay.
But
okay.
In college, maybe study music as a minor.
Well, we wish you good luck with that, for sure.
Thank you.
Yeah, absolutely. So, Angela, for yourself, you know, your feelings going into this performance, why you think it's important?
I don't know. I think it's important just to have the city have another chance to come see us perform our great selection mm-hmm. and know what we can do and support the choir and the city a lot more than they do.
Right, you might be, singing to folks who have not either heard or seen you in the past, as opposed to performing in school, right?
Yeah.
Very good. So good luck. Have fun with it. So, and Matthew, you're leading the tenor section.
Yes. Yeah, it's a lot of fun singing with my peers, even though I'm a section leader. I don't really feel that way. It's mm-hmm. just like being a part of the group. I feel like we just bond and have a good time. It comes naturally.
How did you first get involved with choir?
My first year of high school, I accompanied the choir playing piano, mm-hmm. and I thought it really sounded amazing, so I joined choir the next year.
Okay, all right. And Tim, would you say that's pretty typical of the kids in the group?
It's the choir at the high school level is come one, come all. Yeah. Anybody can take the class at any point in time. So we have some students who continue on from middle school. They're in choir in 6th, 7th, 8th grade. They continue through all 4 years of high school.
Okay.
We have some that even try taking choir as a senior, and out of the blue they'll say, "Oh, you know, I have an elective spot as a senior. I think I'll try it for the first time."
Yeah.
So it's a whole mix. But I wanted to point out that Matthew is going into college for music. He was recently accepted to a couple of colleges. I don't know if you want to say something about that, Matthew.
Well, I got accepted to Berklee College of Music in Boston, and another school, that the one that I'm planning on going to though, is UMass Amherst.
Okay.
I've met the professor there and he's really good, so.
So we may see you on the big stage one day, or in the record store that we used to say our sold folks.
Yeah.
Matthew has really advanced piano skills. Okay. He's an excellent classical pianist.
Okay, and there's different skills, singing and composing and playing.
And he's doing a little composing as well and singing, so he's a man of all trades. So
that's great.
Yeah.
And so folks will see you three at the Tuesday concert, is that right? At the Quincy High concert. Yeah. But the Thursday concert is representatives from North as well, Tim.
I didn't realize
there were two separate choirs.
Yes, and I have about 40 students in each choir.
Okay.
So yeah, and there are separate groups with their own sort of traditions and strengths, and so I try to cater to each high school chorus in their own way.
And what do you hope folks will take out of these performances at the library?
Well, I like what Angela mentioned in terms of bringing the choral program out into a more general public venue. In the public library, where more people can see it, and we're going to, thanks to QATV, we'll get a little more publicity in that sense. So a wider audience, and also a chance for some of their parents and friends and relatives to come and see them again, or for the first time if they missed the spring concert. So just to let everyone know that music is an important part of the curriculum in Quincy Public Schools, and what it means to the students. And you can see as they perform, how much it means to them. And as Leanne said, it is a lot of work, and yet it's a lot of joy and expression as well.
Yeah.
So.
Well, lucky for our viewers, they're going to get a little preview right now of what they might hear at one of the two concerts at the library. We invite folks to stay tuned for that, and want to wish you all a very successful future. Thank you all for coming by. Really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You are very welcome. And don't forget, if you'd like to get more information about this or any of the programs at the library, you can visit their website. It's thomascranelibrary.org.
Can you feel a brand new day? Oh, was an epi de Janus.